So I made an app that allows you to make timestamps from any YouTube video. Check out this video, Orphan Baby Seal Barks at Anyone Who Tries to Clean Her Bathtub. I'm going to copy the URL and paste that into my app. And when I click generate, the app is going to use AI to read the captions of the video and then come up with a suggested set of timestamps. If I would then copy these timestamps and then go to the video, and then I can paste them here in the description of the comment, and then I have a set of chapter titles.
Well, I think it surprises all, and it's one of the first common seals to start eating this way.
So I'm going to show you now how you can make this app very easily without coding knowledge. The whole backend functionality of the app is made in BuildShip. And BuildShip is a tool that allows you to make backends by basically adding and dragging around these rectangular nodes. I've made some content about BuildShip before. Fortunately, they saw it and they liked it. So they're sponsoring this video so I can make more content showing you how to make cool apps. So this is the backend that I made with BuildShip that takes a YouTube video URL and then converts that into captions and then converts those captions using ChatGPT to chapter titles with timestamps. Now, I want to show you how you can make this entirely from scratch. So first, you're going to go to buildship.app. Then we're going to create a brand new workflow. Now I'm going to add a new trigger. We're going to use the REST API call because this is a website backend. And I'll just set the path to be generate because that makes sense for the function that we're calling. And we need to be able to also pass in the URL of the video. And that's going to be passed in as a query parameter. So I'm going to use the get query parameter node. And some of these nodes, you just have to search for them or learn about them. Get query parameter takes the name of the input that we're passing in. And in that case, that's just going to be URL. And that's required. We're going to take this URL and we're going to put it into the YouTube caption extractor node. And so to pass the output of one node into the next, even though you see this arrow here, that arrow means what happens next. It doesn't mean that the output of this will be passed automatically. To do that, we need to find the input here in the video caption node, which is the URL of the YouTube video, and then click here, this pencil, and from variables, we can select the output of the get query parameter node. And this is an essential step when you're building apps with BuildShip, which you're going to repeat often. And then in this case, we're going to do dot query value. Cool. Now, so far, we haven't finished our backend, but we can already test it. And to do that, I'm going to use this test button. And then I'm going to go get the URL of the video that we're testing with. And I'm going to, here under query, put in the query parameter that we just defined. So that would be URL and then the URL. And I'm going to click test workflow. And what that's going to do is it's going to run all of the blocks that I've set up so far. Now, this green arrow here means that the block has been run. And I can actually view the output of that run. Here, the get query parameter block is working. And if I go down to the extract video captions node, I can even view the output of that. And you'll see that this node also ran successfully because I have this subtitles object and it gives me a bunch of mini captions along with the time that caption started. However, there's one issue that I need to solve before I could pass this directly into ChatGPT. And you might see here that the start time is defined as 79 seconds. In our timestamps, we would actually need this to be written as 1 minute and 19 seconds. We need to deal with that before we pass this into ChatGPT because ChatGPT is not really good at doing math. So to do that, I'm going to create a custom node, and that node is going to reformat those timestamps. And this is the most tricky part, but just hang in with me here. I'm going to create a node and I'm going to create an empty node. And now I need to actually create this custom node. So I'm going to click here on this little code icon. So let's go to inputs first. This is a really good place to start. And I want to have one input, and I want that to be captions, which is the array of captions that we got from the last node. And I'm just going to call it captions, and I'm going to set the type to be an array. This should be required. Cool. And maybe under info here, I will just call this caption reformatter. And under description, I'll just put this node converts the timestamps in captions from seconds to minutes seconds. Cool. Now we're ready to put in the code. I'm not going to go through writing all of the code for this node right here, but I will put the link in the description to where you can find the right code. And this is the code that I wrote, and I'm just going to copy that in, and I'm going to paste it here into the node logic. Briefly, what this code is doing is it's taking the list of captions that came out of the last node, and for each one, it's keeping the same text, but it's changing the timestamp by using this conversion function here. Additionally, I'm doing one more trick in this function. which is if the array gets too long, it may actually be too much for ChatGPT and cause it to return an error because there's a maximum token input size. So I'm also checking if the array gets too long, and if it is too long, I'm shortening the text in the captions until it gets to be the right length. And then the last thing we need to do before we're ready to use this node is we need to set the output type. And then the output type of this is going to be an array because it's an array of captions marked by each timestamp. So when I'm ready to use the node, I'm just going to click save. And I might also have to rename this node to something like caption reformatter so that we have a nice way to refer back to it later on. And I'm going to click test again, and I'm going to go get that URL and put in URL here so I can test the whole workflow again. And now this is green, which means that it ran successfully. And if we click here, we see that we get the right captions, but now we also get the timestamps in the format that we need. So we're nearly finished, and we're just going to add a couple more blocks, and one of those is going to be the ChatGPT block. But before we can pass these captions into the ChatGPT block, we need to convert this array into a string. And it's fine if we do that using the stringify JSON block, because ChatGPT understands JSON just fine. And to do that, I'm going to use this pencil again, and I'm going to go under variables, and I'm going to select the array from caption reformatter. So now if we run the test again, we see that's green. And here we have the same output as before, but now we know for sure that this is a string, and that's something that can be passed to the chat block. So let's add the chat block, and I'm going to select OpenAI chat. And now I need to get my API key from OpenAI. So just look away for a second. Okay. So there's my API key. And you always need to have a system prompt. The default system prompt is you are a helpful assistant. And that works fine. For the model, let's use GPT 3.5 Turbo. It's super fast. And now, most importantly, we need to add the prompt. So that's here under user request, and I can use this pencil icon here. And what I want to do for the prompt is I actually want to combine the stringified JSON from the last node, and I want to add my own special prompt after that to tell ChatGPT what to do with it. So I'm going to use templating syntax, which consists of these two backtick characters. And then inside of those characters, I'm going to insert the stringified JSON. I don't know why it added these extra backticks here, but I'm just going to remove those. And then after this JSON here, I'll be inserting my carefully prepared prompts, which are also linked to in the description of this video. And I will copy and paste that here into the templated string. Now that this is finished, let's try and run it again. So I'm going to click test workflow. So that came up as green, which means there were no errors, but now we get to see if it actually worked. So here I see one long string, and in there, there's a bunch of timestamps in the correct format, which have to do with the video about the baby seal. Good. Are we finished now? Actually, there's one more step we need to do to make this ready for production. And I just need to add one final return block. Perfect. So this is the return block. And assuming that there's no errors, we're going to give a status code of okay. And then the output of the return block is just going to be the value of the last block. And that was the chat block. Let's run everything one more time. We got a little bit different chapter titles this time, but it's still working. And then to put this into production, all that I have to do is click ship. So that gives me a URL of the API, which I can use from the front end of my application. So I've already made a very simple front end for this application. I just generated it using Gitwit, and I've downloaded and exported the code into an open source repo, which is here on my GitHub. And I'll put a link to this so that anyone else can reproduce this app if they want to. Then I just signed into my Netlify account, which is a free host, and I connected to my GitHub and the repo that I just made, and I just deployed that. And that's how I got this app working. I have a bunch of other ideas for stuff to build with BuildShip. For example, I thought maybe it would be cool to turn this into a custom GPT or maybe a Slack bot. If you have some cool ideas for me to build, let me know. And yeah, hope to see you next time.